Welcome to the new vlog.
It is now April. No, it's not April. It's May. So, one of the goals for this month is to do a painting, like an actual, like, whole painting. Last month, one of the goals was to start drawing again, so I did this, this is like a bag I glued into the page. I did this, like, some sketches, some, like, practice drawings or studies of Stevie Nicks on that. So that was, like, just me trying to get back into drawing, like, jumpstart that, skill again. I've been drawing for, like, my whole life, but I haven't done anything artistic, like, drawing, painting, or anything in a couple years, so I wanted to, like, ease my way back into it. So last month I started drawing again, and this month is a painting. In high school I did a couple paintings, but they weren't very good because I said in one of my videos recently that I don't think I was ever a good painter. So I just want to kind of try to build that skill this year. So do a couple paintings, like, actually try and take the time to see if I can actually paint and do it well, like hone the craft. Or is it, it's not own the craft, right? It's hone the craft. I don't know. This painting I'm doing now, I've started planning it out. Basically my inspiration for this painting, what I want to kind of do is make it like a Renaissance painting. I'll show examples here. So make the paintings look like somebody sitting in like a dark room and you just like see their face. I don't know, I've just always liked that kind of painting and I want to try to do that kind of style. So I found this picture that I'll also put of Downey, and because I was scrolling through my camera roll trying to find a picture that I want to paint or some inspiration references or whatever, and I just found that photo and I thought it'd be perfect for this kind of test in the Renaissance style because I've never painted in that style before. So I thought I'd do that. Then there's these paintings by 16th century painter from like the Renaissance era, Hans Holbein the Younger or whatever. I don't know. It'll be there. He did like these circle paintings and I don't know if it was just like something he did or if a lot of people did them. I don't know, but I like his paintings. So then I was like, I want to do, because I really like this circle motif. Is that, can I call it a motif? Just the circle shape? That's like probably my favorite shape. So then I was like, I'm gonna do a picture of Downey in Renaissance style, like this painter's paintings in like a circle shape. And so I'm gonna try to tie that all together. And I've got my planning started here. So you can see, that's, it'll be Downey kind of like that in a circle with this kind of style. And I'm going to do some practice painting on this page right here to see colors and what I can do. And then probably next week, maybe this weekend, I will start the actual painting on the canvas or sketching it out, whatever. I don't know. I'll film parts of it. So that's like the big thing this month. The painting also, I'll show you at the end of this vlog, probably. This vlog will probably be a month long. Not a month long, but you know what I mean? Like, it's gonna be a whole month in a vlog. Because I want you to see the beginning and the end of this painting. New vlog. New moment. 2020 is my Renaissance. That was the plan before, you know, a certain virus kind of got involved in the situation. But still, the plan for this year is a Renaissance era for myself. So here we go. I'm very excited though. You'll see more in a second. Yesterday, I did a little bit of painting the idea, sort of. So I tried to do that, like, in that style. Right? And I'm actually surprised that it's not that bad, but it's so small that I couldn't get the detail at all. But on the bigger painting, of course, it'll be more detailed and more... I'm gonna make sure that it's good. That was just a quick practice to get kind of the idea of the colors and stuff like that. So I did that. And then today I went to Michael's because I had to get some supplies. So I bought a palette knife. I don't have a lot of money, so I couldn't buy everything in the world. And I wish that I could do this painting with oil paint, but there's a couple reasons why I'm not doing oil paint and why I'm doing acrylic instead. First of all, oil paint is expensive, more expensive than acrylic. And I just can't be spending more than I can afford right now. So that's number one. Number two, oil paints are harder to use, at least for me personally. They're messier and they take longer to dry. They're just more difficult to use. It takes a while to do an oil painting and you have to let it dry and then like put layers on it. And you have to clean your brushes with special solvent or whatever because the oil paint is so strong. And it's not water-based, so you can't just rinse it out of a brush like acrylic, because acrylic is water-based. It's more like plastic. So I think there's people that don't really like to use acrylic. A lot of people use gouache, which is similar to acrylic, I think, but I've only used gouache once, and that's also more expensive. So anyway, I'm using acrylic, but sometime in the future, when I have more money, I'm gonna try to do oil paints. So I got palette knife, then I got a new palette. It's just a cheap palette, plastic. Environmentally, that sounds bad now, saying like plastic is like a bad word now. So I've got this. Then I got some gold, like, I think this is acrylic, but it's basically just like a metallic gold paint. It's because I'm going to do a little bit of gold in the painting. It's very Renaissance, I think, to do some gold. And in the painting that I kind of am getting my inspiration from has some hints of gold around the circle. So we're going to do something with the gold. Then I needed square canvas. I was like, get one square canvas because I have a couple canvases, but they're more like a rectangle or whatever. I don't know, they're like a standard canvas shape. So I needed to get a square canvas because this is going to be a square painting. And so I was going to get a white one, but then I found black canvases. And these came in packs of two. They didn't have just one, so I would have gotten just one. But it came in packs of two, and I was like, might as well take two. So yeah, black canvases. How crazy is that? I've never, like, I didn't know that these existed. So I got that because that's what I'm going to do the actual painting on. Then I found these really cute little ones. So this also came in packs of two, but they're super cute little black canvases. These are 5x5. So I'm going to do another practice one on this, but do it as close to what I'm going to do with the official painting instead of what I did in my sketchbook, which was just like super quick and little. And they're so cute. Look at how it's smaller than my head. So I'm going to do this one first. I'm going to do the same exact painting, but in a small version. Then we'll do the big official one. I'll probably start it next week. Yeah. Anyway, that's very exciting, I think. I'm going to try to tie-dye this, like, cream-colored champion hoodie, but I'm testing out a new, like, method that
to like make the dye stronger, first I'm gonna soak it in warm water. It's in this bowl. Warm water and a bunch of salt. But now I don't think this will even fit in the bowl. It's not gonna fit in the bowl. Water's getting everywhere. Hold on. But I think salt can make the dyeing stronger, or like trigger something in the fabric to make it absorb color or change color quicker or something. I don't know. Whoa, this is hot water too. So anyway, I'm gonna let this soak and then we'll dye it. And I'm gonna bleach stuff while this soaks. Okay, I'm just gonna let that sit and we'll bleach.
I can't recall a time before longing to redeem, or to be forgiven by a daughter when you need. Yet not all of us will be. Oh.
So I've got a couple of these going on right now. Ones that I bleached, I'm gonna leave for a little bit to try to get as light as they can, and then I'll rinse them out. One that I tie-dyed, I'll show you. All right, so that is bleached. Okay, so that one is bleached. Parts of it got really light and then parts of it are not, and so I'm just gonna leave that for maybe an hour, see what happens. That one, like, didn't bleach at all, and that's one of my big frustrations, because now I'm like, what is that gonna look like? So I'm gonna leave that as long as I can. That is a t-shirt, and it bleached all right. I'll just leave it. I'm gonna ultimately leave these out for an hour, and then I'll rinse this one out and that one. I'm gonna leave that one until tonight. I'll show you when they're done, so we'll see. Okay, so welcome back to tie-dyeing things. There's people out all around my house cutting trees, so if you're hearing that noise, that's what that is. This hoodie that I was gonna tie-dye, I showed you me tie-dyeing it. The tie-dye wasn't enough because it was like a cream-colored hoodie and I wanted it to be more color than just a couple spots, and that wasn't working enough. So I laid out the whole hoodie on the floor and basically covered it in dye. I'll put a picture of what it looked like, and it was a mess, right? But I was like, it's fine, because the plan now is to bleach it. So I'm going like all around doing, like, dyeing it, then bleaching it. What am I doing? So, started out cream colored. I dyed it all over with color. Now we're doing a bleach, because honestly, I think I like the look of bleach more than tie-dye designs. Bleach designs look cooler and work better than tie-dye designs
that's how I'm starting to feel about all these after I've done a couple projects. All of my bleach projects look pretty much amazing, and all of my tie-dye projects do not look good. So basically I made this a colored hoodie, now we're gonna bleach it so that it'll look even cooler, and hopefully it actually works. Anyway, I just did that, so we got it tied up in a spun. So I've got it now all twisted, and I've got the rubber bands, and I'm going to bleach sections, and then we will see how it looks. I think this one will be so much better, but it just was not working with the tie-dye, so I'll show you when it's done.
I can't recall a time before the longing to redeem.
Oh, look at how weird they look.
There's another one in there. A what?
They don't normally come that color.
Oh.
So I finished the little painting. I think it's pretty good. I didn't try to really work super hard on it because obviously this is just a practice run and I'm doing the bigger piece, but that's kind of what it looks like. I mean, that is what it looks like. I don't know why I said kind of. And the painting that I'm taking the inspiration from had gold around the edge of the circle and gold lettering, so I just tried to do that too. And it says Tony Stark or Anthony Stark in Italian. The Stark, I just googled Stark in Italian and that's what it came up with, so I don't know. But so this is the practice mini version of the bigger one I'm gonna do. I'm gonna definitely try to do way better than this. This was just the mini. This is gonna be the size of the bigger one. There's the canvas. Thank you.
morning tide, when the sparrow and the seagull fly. Jonathan and Everly in the entire.
Congratulations,
Edward. It doesn't say
or he's
that.
A third.
Cool, man. You did a good job.
I spelled it right. What do you want me to say? All in today's work.
All in today's work.
I'm gonna show you the results of the bleaching stuff that I did. It's now been multiple weeks since that, and I almost don't remember which clothes I was working on. I think I know. I almost don't know. I think I know though. Some of them turned out amazing. I'll start out with the least amazing, and then we'll get to the rest. Should I sit down? All right, I'll sit. Okay. So this was a red champion hoodie, and the hood is gone because I cut it off to sew onto, I'll show you, a couple months ago. Maybe a year ago, I don't know how long it's been. I cut the hood off of this hoodie to sew onto this Ariana Grande sweatshirt. And this was just a regular sweatshirt without a hood. So I sewed the hoodie on. Let me see. And then I also cut the bottom off to crop it. Let me see what it looks like. It's not a finished product because, and I also cut it there. It's not a finished product. It is cropped now because I cropped it. If you can see the back there, I am, hold on, now I'm taking it off. The hood is very big though. So it's kind of like not, I don't know. It's very big for me, but. So the back here, it's just like white lettering, this whole back part, but I'm embroidering over that. I don't know if you can see. So I've gotten the Ariana part done, but then I ran out of red floss for embroidery. So I'm gonna get some more red floss sometime and do the grande part, and then that'll be embroidered there. And yeah, so this is a project that's not done yet, but that's where the hood went on that. So this sweatshirt is missing a hood, and I don't wear it because I kinda just bought it just to use for random projects. So the hood's gone and it looks kinda weird. That's why I bleached it, because I was like, I wanna see what it would look like. This one was a pain to bleach. It didn't want to bleach. This is like the pants of the last vlog. I had to let it sit for like 2 days or something in order to get this light at all. And it's not the best, but it's kind of cool. I don't know if you can see it. It turned out all right. I like it more than I thought that I would because it was kind of a pain to do, but that was just really for fun. Then I did this green one, which this one I actually really like. There's not really much of a cool pattern, but I do enjoy looking at it when it's on my rack. It looks pretty cool. So that's that one. Then I have this champion hoodie, which also is one that I bought for a DIY that I didn't end up doing. So, sitting. So this one was like a cream colored one. I tried to put color in it, and then the color, I'm trying to remember now because this was weeks ago, the color didn't really hold the way that I wanted it to. Well, the color was vibrant because now I know to leave it for a long time, but it wasn't a cool pattern. I did a tie-dye way of doing it, and the pattern was like, it wasn't enough color, it looked lame. So then I put it I laid it out in the garage, and I just basically put so much color all over it. I used up the whole bottles of the colors that I was using, and I just colored the whole entire thing, and it looked like a mess and looked kind of crazy. I've got a picture that I can show of what it looked like, and I was like, this could be a huge mistake. But the plan was to color it, then bleach it, because I think bleach is the best way to do things. The best design that I prefer is bleaching, the best method. So when something's already colored, then you bleach it, it looks the coolest. Tie-dyeing to me is not looking so great the way that I'm doing it. I don't like it. So I was like, okay, then I'll color it and then bleach it. So that's what I did. And it looks pretty cool. It's a little bit crazy and messy, but I think it's interesting. It's kind of hard to show. So it was super duper colored all over. Then I bleached it to create more of this like swirl design with the lines. So the bleaching was what created the more interesting design that you can follow, and the colors, all the colors I put on myself with the tie-dye dye, and I think it ended up pretty cool. And I got the little strings also colored. So yeah, this one I do like. It's kind of really similar to the Halsey one, but it's a little bit more vibrant colors because I left it longer. And this is a little bit crazier. This one's a little softer. Then the last thing, which is literally the best. This is one of the best ones I've ever done ever. When I rinsed this out, I was astonished. I was literally like flipping out. I was like, this is so cool. I freaking love it. Okay, so ready? You might be like, this is lame. Look at it now. You don't know what it looked like before, but look at that. Look at that. Okay, look at this. This. Oh my God. Look at how that happened. I don't know how I did that. I literally just twisted it up and then did the rubber bands like I do and bleached some sections, and it turned out so well. I think it is so, maybe it's not as cool as I think it is, but I think it's incredible. It's like perfect. It looks like crazy, like lightning. It's amazing. The colors are perfect. I don't even know what to say. I think this is my most successful bleach project yet. Yeah, seriously, I think this is the one. I don't think I have another that's as good as this. This is so perfect. So anyway, that's, I think, all the ones that I did. So that's the final results. I'm just like shocked by this one. I am just blown away. So I'm gonna be doing more things in the future with bleaching because this is now my favorite thing to do. It's so fun. And it's just like, that's like stuff that you would like probably want to buy, right? From like Urban Outfitters, but I did it myself. So cool. Some projects don't turn out perfect, but that's what's amazing. Everything is unique. And now I'm like really like getting the hang of it. So I think I'm going to be able to make, I'm going to be able to like really know what I'm doing. So that's the result of those, and I'll do more in the future.
About Eve, I've acted pretty disgracefully toward her, too. Well, don't fumble for excuses, not here and now with my hair down. At best, let's say I've been oversensitive to her. Well, to the fact that she's so young, so feminine and so helpless. To so many things I want to be for Bill. Funny business, a woman's career. The things you drop on your way up the ladder so you can move faster. You forget you'll need them again when you get back to being a woman. It's one career all females have in common, whether we like it or not. Being a woman. Sooner or later, we've got to work at it. No matter how many other careers we've had or wanted. And in the last analysis, nothing's any good unless you can look up just before dinner or turn around in bed. And there he is. Without that, you're not a woman. You're something with a French provincial office or a book full of clippings. But you're not a woman. Slow curtain, the end.